Welcome, welcome. Come on in. Welcome to the Restoration Church Ministries. It's Pastor Gerald Adams. We own no rights to any of the music playing in the background. We own no rights to any of the music playing in the background. God bless you, Sister Karen. God bless you this morning. Good to see you. Good morning, Miss Sharon. Good to see you this morning. God bless you. Good morning, Sister Shinovia. Good to see you this morning. God bless you. Great Sunday school lesson this morning. God bless you. Finish strong. God bless you, Miss Bonnie. Good to see you this morning. God bless you. God bless you. And God bless you. Hallelujah. God bless each and every one of you. Welcome to the Restoration Church Ministries. This is Pastor Gerald Adams. It is an honor, privilege, and a pleasure to be with you this morning to spend this time in biblical study with you. God bless each and every one of you. I thank God for you. We do not take your time lightly. So we want to go into God's word to be a blessing to you and to go out and enjoy this beautiful day that he has given. So we thank God yet again for you, and you tuning in today. If you have your Bibles, we're going to look at a passage of scripture found in Philippians, the third chapter. Philippians, the third chapter. God bless you, Deacon Adams. Good to see you this morning. Great Sunday school lesson. Great Sunday school lesson. God bless you. Philippians, the third chapter. But as we do, before we start to do anything, let us invoke the presence of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So let us bow our heads in a word of prayer before we get started. So Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus, we thank you for your goodness, your kindness, God. We thank you for your mercy, Lord. We thank you for just being who you are to us, oh God. Thank you for saving us. Thank you for blessing us. Thank you, oh God, for going to the cross for us and delivering us, oh God, out of the hands of the enemy, oh God. We thank you, oh God, yet again, oh God, that you have brought us to this hour to share one with another, oh God, in fellowship, oh God. We thank you for each and every person that's on the line today, the hearers of this word, oh God. We ask that you bless them in a special way, oh God. We pray right now, God, that they would be edified, oh God, that you would be glorified and the demons of hell terrified by the power of the Holy Spirit going forth through the airway, God. We ask today that you bless your people, God, and that you heal them from the crown of their heads to the sole of their feet. If there's anyone listening now under the sound of my voice and dealing with any sickness or illness in their bodies right this very hour, we pray healing to come to them now in Jesus' name. Bless your word, oh God, and make it a blessing, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. Philippians, the third chapter. Philippians, the third chapter. Very, very familiar passage of scripture. Very familiar passage of scripture. Starting at verse number 13. God bless you. Excuse me. God bless you, Aunt Willamy. Good to see you this morning. God bless you. Philippians, the third chapter. Very, very familiar passage of scripture. I just want to read two verses in your hearing. Starting at verse 13. Brethren, I count it not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before. I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, hearing, and doing of his holy word. I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. I want to speak to you this morning, if you would allow me to, from the subject matter, determined to finish strong. Determined to finish strong. Good morning, Miss Lisa. God bless you this morning. Determined to finish strong. We have the last first Sunday of 2023. We're in December of 2022. Jumping ahead of myself. 2022. And so this is the last first Sunday of the year. Praise the name of our God. And so we have gone through this entire year of 2022. And we are ultimately coming toward the end of it. Many of us have seen, hallelujah, so many different things throughout this year. So we've had to have so many different challenges throughout the year. Some good, some bad. Praise the name of our God. But we now come to, hallelujah, the crowning point of 2022, where we are at the near end of it. And so here we want to say, hallelujah, if you have made it this far, if you have made it to the first Sunday, December the 4th in 2022, then be determined to have a strong finish. God bless you, Brother Dale. Good to see you this morning. Determined to finish strong. Determined. Determined. I'm going to say it again. Determined. Determined is an adjective, and it means having to a firm decision and being resolved not to change it. To have made a firm decision and being resolved not to change it. A determined person is someone who is extremely motivated and unlikely to quit or change their mind. So my question to you today, coming to the end of 2022, what have you been committed to this year? What have you determined in your heart to finish this year? Hallelujah. How many of us started off good, started off quick, but they just fell by the wayside as life went on? The success in Christian living or in the Christian's life is not measured by how fast they sprint away from the starting line. No, it is not, hallelujah, measured that way. Victory and success is won by running the full race, including the home stretch. We're in the home stretch of 2022. Praise the name of our God. And it's not going to be determined how we started January 1st, 2022, but how we end in December of 2022. We're in the home stretch, praise the name of our God. And we must finish strong. Hallelujah. It's determined how we cross the finish line. Praise the name of our God. God bless you, my dear sister Jocelyn. Ecclesiastes 9 and 11 says the race is not to the swift. Hallelujah. What does that simply mean? That simply means it doesn't matter how fast you get off to a good start. Hallelujah. But it matters how you end the race. Psalms 90 and 10 says, praise the name of our God, the days of our years are 70 years and 10. And if by reason of strength they be 80, hallelujah, yet is their strength, labor, and sorrow. In other words, it does not matter what you do. Praise the name of our God in the first 10 to 20 years of life. Hallelujah. But it matters how you bring it all to an end. Hallelujah. 2022, we have seen many generals of our faith, many mothers of our faith, go on to be with the Lord, praise the name of our God. And it's always said at their funerals, I've heard a few of them say that they ended well. Praise the name of our God. In other words, they didn't, hallelujah, it didn't matter that they sprinted out in the beginning. It mattered how they ended. And I praise the name of our God. And my pastor from my home church, he had this sermon that he preached, a series that he preached, and he called it the long game. Hallelujah. So it is important. Praise the name of our God. Just like Apostle Jackson would say, hallelujah, we must be, hallelujah, and pay attention to the long game. And so, in other words, we must finish strong. And it's not a sprint. This thing called life is not a sprint. It's a long distance race with the goal of crossing the finish line still upright and still going forward. Praise the name of our God. You don't want to get, praise the name of our God, too close to the finish line and then start to falter. There must be a determination and a commitment to finish. Hallelujah. As a Marine, praise the name of our God, we used to have this thing called a physical fitness test. Praise the name of our God. We would take these physical fitness tests at least twice a year. In this test, we would have to, hallelujah, do 20 pull-ups, 80 sit-ups in 2 minutes, and then run it 3 miles. Hallelujah. As a former runner, I found out, hallelujah, very, very quickly, hallelujah, that you cannot use all of your energy in the very first mile. Hallelujah. But when you, hallelujah, begin to run, that you must start to pace yourselves. Hallelujah. Some of us that when we were running, praise the name of our God. Hallelujah. When we began to pace ourselves, hallelujah, that meant that we ran the 3 mile mark in a 6 minute mile. We ran a 6 minute mile. For others, it meant a 7 minute mile. For others, it could have meant an 8 minute mile. Hallelujah. But at the end of the day, hallelujah, the goal was to finish. It wasn't hallelujah, but regardless of how long you took to finish, hallelujah, the administrators of the test, praise the name of our God, they weren't looking at how fast you took off or how fast you began the race. Hallelujah, their evaluation was determined, hallelujah, of you on how well you finished. Oh God, I give you glory. Hallelujah. They weren't evaluating your physical fitness based on, hallelujah, how quickly, hallelujah, you finished running. Hallelujah. But they were actually wondering, and they wanted to see the strength that you had coming over the finish line. Hallelujah. They wanted to see if you were determined and committed to finish. Here in our Christian race we call life, God is not looking for how fast we start, but he is looking for how well we finish. Because as well, hallelujah, we all know it is easier to start than it is to finish. Many of us can think of different projects, praise the name of our God, even in this year, in 2022, how we have started with great zeal, but ran out of steam in the middle of the year, praise the name of our God. When we look in the Word of God, we find three ways that leaders, hallelujah, in the Bible, finish their journey. When you look into the Word of God, there are examples all over the place. The first thing, hallelujah, that you find in the Word of God, and these leaders, number one, they were those who never finish. I just want y'all to follow me here. Hallelujah. They had great potential when they started. Hallelujah. They had great, hallelujah, zeal when they started. But at some point, praise the name of our God, something happened. Hallelujah. And they lost sight of why they were running. Hallelujah. And they quit before they're finished. Hallelujah. Such leaders such as Samson, who lost his sight, praise the name of our God, because he lost sight oh God, of the one who sent him. Oh God, then it was Saul who, hallelujah, eventually got killed, hallelujah, by the ones that God himself told him to kill. Hallelujah, if you don't kill what God told you to kill, hallelujah, eventually that thing that God told you to kill in your life will come back and kill you. Oh God, I give you glory. Hallelujah. And their lives ended tragically. Oh God, I give you glory. There are those who never finish. The next example are those, or secondly, they are those who finish limping. You got those who finish or never finish, but then you have those that would finish limping. They ran, hallelujah, the first part of their race, hallelujah, well, but then somewhere along the course, hallelujah, they took a detour or a shortcut, hallelujah, to keep them from being fully effective in what God had called them to do. Such leaders as Eli, you remember Eli, hallelujah, that had the sons, hallelujah, that was doing all sorts of things, the priest that had the sons doing all sorts of things in the temple. You had Gideon, you had Solomon with over 700 wives. Even though they finished, hallelujah, they had a weak finish. In other words, they limped over the finish line. They barely got there, praise the name of our God. But then you have those in the Bible, when you look at, hallelujah, how well they finish. The, hallelujah, the last one of those that is in this group that finish strong. And I want each and every one of you to be in this group. I need to be in this group. Hallelujah. They completed what God had given them to do. Thus, I'm talking about finishing strong today. Even though they weren't perfect people, and none of us are perfect people, praise the name of our God, they enjoyed deepening their relationship and intimacy with God throughout their lifetime. Hallelujah. People like Abraham. Hallelujah. Abraham was called, hallelujah, from the Chaldeans, under his father's roof, hallelujah, to go out and deepen his relationship with God. Moses, hallelujah, after, hallelujah, he had killed a man, God sent him on the backside. He ran to the backside of the desert, but God sent him right back into Egypt to deliver over a million people from bondage. But Moses finished his race strong. Hallelujah. You have David. David also, hallelujah, finished his race strong. Hallelujah. Last but not least, we have even our writer of today, the Apostle Paul. He ended his race strong. They never stopped learning or growing, even in their mature age, or their being mature leaders. They were always looking to please God. Hallelujah. And if you desire to finish your race strong, then you must begin to look to please God. Hallelujah. They kept on, hallelujah, wanting, even though they made mistakes, they always wanted to please God. Hallelujah. And as believers in Christ, we too must learn, hallelujah, from our mistakes. All the people in the Bible, they weren't perfect, just like you and I are not perfect, but we must learn, hallelujah, from our mistakes. Because one of the biggest hindrances to finishing strong is life, hallelujah, and life is our past. Hallelujah. I want you all to get this. Just follow me here today. One of the biggest hindrances, even though when we start off strong and we start off fast, praise the name of our God, one of the hindrances that could stop what we're doing in life for God is our past. For some, hallelujah, through the fault of their own, not of any fault of their own, they find themselves, hallelujah, in trouble even from the very start. Hallelujah. And in other words, they grow up in a broken home. Hallelujah. They grew up with divorced parents. They grew up in poverty. They might have been, had to deal with alcoholism. Hallelujah. They might have been, hallelujah, dealing with things, hallelujah, that just interrupted or in their family tree, praise the name of our God. They found themselves being, hallelujah, the one supporting their families, hallelujah. You have children today, hallelujah, that's out here supporting their parents simply because parents didn't do what they were supposed to do. And that child is having a rough life, praise the name of our God. Hallelujah. They have faced so many obstacles in their life. Hallelujah. Until they start off in a bad situation. Hallelujah. They may start off, hallelujah, being pregnant in high school. Hallelujah. They may have started off, praise the name of our God, not being able to keep a job. Hallelujah. Their business might have went under. Hallelujah. They might have, hallelujah, health crises that continue to come up in their lives. Or they might have been dealing with the divorce of a marriage. Hallelujah. Struggling with hitting addictions and insecurities. Hallelujah. But I came by to encourage somebody today that you can still finish strong. Hallelujah. How, with all of these things, Pastor Adams, with all of these life challenges, how are we able to finish strong? Hallelujah. You might be asking, I've had to deal with some of these issues that you have named today. Hallelujah. I might have been a pregnant teen. Hallelujah. And my life had never really, hallelujah, got started. I might have had to deal with a broken marriage. Oh God, I give you glory. I might have had to deal with losing everything that I own because my business failed. How can I finish strong when I've had to deal with so many problems and situations of life? Oh, I'm so glad that you asked. Oh God, because Paul here, hallelujah, in the text today, hallelujah, Paul tells us how we can finish strong. How do we finish strong when you've had to deal and go through so many things? It's found right here in the first two words of the text. Hallelujah. When you look at verse number 14, Paul says, I press. It comes from the Greek word diokor. Hallelujah. Diokor. Hallelujah. Which means to pursue in a hostile manner. What are you saying, Pastor Adams? In other words, Paul says, with the same hostility and zeal that I pursued and, hallelujah, persecuted the church. Hallelujah. I'm going to pursue Jesus and with the same type of zeal, with the same type of hostility toward the enemy. And Paul says here, when he starts to talk about the press, he begins by telling the church at Philippi, here in verse number 10, he simply says, I'm not there yet. Hallelujah. When you're dealing with finishing strong, the first thing you have to understand is the press. And Paul tells the church, hallelujah, I'm not there yet. He says, although I'm circumcised the eighth day and the stock of Israel, he says, I'm of the tribe of Benjamin, I'm a Hebrew of Hebrews touching the law. He says, even though I am a Pharisee, I'm not there yet. Concerning zeal persecuting the church, touching the righteousness which is in the law, I was blameless at the time, but I'm still not there yet. Counting all things lost for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, but church, I'm not there yet. Paul tells the church, although you see where I'm headed, although you see that there is a gift that God has given me, I'm simply not there yet. When we look at the life of Paul, it is so easy to forget that Paul had quite a past. Hallelujah. What are you talking about, Pastor Adams? Paul had been, hallelujah, a holier than thou believer. He was a legalistic Pharisee, the type that Jesus often preach about himself. Hallelujah. Paul, praise the name of our God. To even make matters worse with Paul, he was so oppressed, hallelujah, and oppressive of the followers of Christ, that, hallelujah, he felt, praise the name of our God, that it was that God had called him and it was God's mission to him, that he would rid the world of all of Jesus' followers. In other words, what Paul was saying, that Paul was a modern day terrorist. He felt that God wanted him, hallelujah, to kill all of the infidels and kill them, hallelujah. And certainly he tried to kill them all. Hallelujah. hallelujah, Paul, praise the name of our God, had such a bad past and reputation that when he became a Christian himself, and he went to church, hallelujah, to worship God with his fellow brothers and sisters, people ran away from Paul, hallelujah, not believing that this kind of person could ever be changed. Isn't it like that in church today? People that know where you came from, they might have known how you were in your past. They won't let you get past what you have done. Oh God, I give you glory. But I came by to tell you that you don't have to allow your past, just like the Apostle Paul, to sabotage your future. So many of us stop doing what God has called us to do because the enemy reminds us of our past. But the Apostle Paul tells us to not allow the past to sabotage your future. He says it here in the word. How many of us, hallelujah, are dealing with the same kind of past, dealing with the same types of issues, issues that are keeping us from finishing strong? How many of us are dealing, hallelujah, with family members, hallelujah, that's keeping us stuck in the same place day in and day out? How many of us are dealing with addictions that we just can't seem to get rid of? Secret sins, drinking in privacy, looking at things on the internet that we should not be looking at. Oh God, I give you glory. Paul says here in the word, don't allow your past to sabotage your future. Issues that are keeping you from finishing. When people begin running, hallelujah, running from Paul, he could have allowed it to sabotage his past. He could have allowed his past to sabotage his future, rather. He could have allowed it to make him give up on his calling. He could have allowed it to make him turn back on Jesus. He could have allowed it, hallelujah, to make him say, man, and throw his hands up and say, forget this. We know, praise the name of our God, that because Paul is the writer of 2/3 of the New Testament, that he pressed his way. We know this, hallelujah, because he shares with us his secret to how to finish strong. According to Paul, the first key to finishing strong is not allowing your past to sabotage your future. In other words, he says forgetting what is behind. With the past, hallelujah, like Paul, you would think Jesus would have, hallelujah, no use for a person like him. With a past like Paul, you would think that Jesus would strike him down. Oh God, I give you glory. But how many of us, hallelujah, know that Jesus can take our past and make it a prize for our very future when we begin to press our way like Paul says? We find out, hallelujah, that in Romans 8:28, we find out that all things work together for good for each and every one of us who loves the Lord and are called according to his purpose. When we begin to press, we find out, hallelujah, that his word becomes a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. When we begin to press into God, we find out, like Isaiah tells us in Isaiah 42:16, he says he will make the darkness light before us. Oh God, I give you praise. The songwriter Charles Price, Jones took it a little bit further when he said in a writing of the greatest song, one of the greatest songs that was ever written, he says, I will make the darkness light before thee. Hallelujah. He got that from Isaiah. But he went on to say, hallelujah, what is wrong, I'll make it right before thee. All your battles, I will fight before thee, and the high places I will bring down. Jesus is telling you today that when you walk by the way, he said, I'll lead thee on the fatness of the land. He promised to feed thee the mansions in the sky. He promised to deed thee and all the high places. Hallelujah, that the enemy has for you, that the enemy been trying to stop you. Jesus says, I'll bring them down. You can finish strong. I came by to tell you. I came by to let somebody know. It does not matter how you feel this morning. It does not matter if your body is racked with pain. You can finish strong. I know, hallelujah, that some of us are dealing with problems and situations in life, but you can finish strong. When we press into God, we are positioning ourselves to finish this race strong. For there is a word from God. Hallelujah. In throughout his word, God helps us to understand through all situations in life, you can finish strong. You don't believe me? When things seem to go bad and go from bad to worse, all you have to do is shout with a loud voice. Romans 8:28. All things work together for the good for those that love the Lord and who are called according to his purpose. When you feel like you won't make it at all, you declare with a loud voice, Philippians 1:6, he who began a good work in me will carry it out to completion by Christ Jesus. When you feel like God has abandoned you, all you have to do is declare with a loud voice, Hebrews 13:5, he will never leave me, and he promised never to forsake me. When you feel like all hope is lost, all you have to do is shout it like David says in Psalms 23, surely goodness and mercy is following me all the days of my life. Oh God, I give you glory. The first key that I wanted to leave you with when you want to finish strong is not to let your past sabotage your future. Hallelujah. The second key, and I promise I'll get on out of your way to finishing strong, is reaching out for Jesus. The first key is not to let your past or the naysayers or what you did sabotage your future. But the second key is most important of them all, is to reach out for Jesus. In other words, to finish strong. I'm going to reach out for Christ, who has so wondrously reached out for me. It is like a child running towards a parent with outstretched arms, with great waiting, with great anticipation of daddy and mommy lifting them up. Paul says it here, not only do I forget those things in my past, But I think, hallelujah, about those things. I forget about those things that I think disqualifies me for Jesus' love. But I run with enthusiasm toward Jesus with outstretched arms, knowing that he will lift me up out of my situation and circumstances. So I'm determined to finish strong. I came by to tell somebody, have you reached out for Jesus lately? Have you reached out and give him your problems? Have you reached out to him in 2022? It's coming to an end. I know some of us got a bad doctor's report in the early stages of 2022, but I came to tell you in December of 2022, you are still here, so you can finish strong. I know some of us at the beginning of 2022 had lost our jobs, but you still ate. You still have a roof over your head. You still have gas to drive your car, and you are still here, so you can finish strong. There are so many that's willing. Hallelujah. How many of you are willing to reach out for Jesus? Hallelujah. Joshua was determined to finish strong. Joshua 24:15. He said to the children of Israel, if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose ye this day who you will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites, or those are in the land in which you dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Joshua was determined to finish strong. David was determined to finish strong. He said it this way in Psalms 37 and 25. I've been young and now I'm old, but yet I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging for bread. David was determined to finish strong when he told Solomon, now that you're on the throne, be strong in the Lord and be courageous, for he will not leave you, or he will not forsake you until you have completed what he has called you to do. David was determined to finish strong, and he wanted his son to do the same. David was determined to do it God's way. Even though he made mistakes, he wanted to finish strong. Jesus was determined to finish strong. In Luke 4 and 18, he begins his ministry by simply telling the church, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the good tidings of the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, recovering sight to the blind, to set at liberty those that were abused, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. In the middle of his ministry, we find him, hallelujah, in a garden, sweating blood, saying, Father, if it be thy will, Remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. It does not matter that you get a little weak in the middle of the race. Learn to pace yourself in order to finish strong. Jesus paced himself. Not my will, but your will be done. He paced himself to the cross of Calvary, because at the end of his earthly ministry, we find him saying, the Bible tells us that when Jesus, knowing all things had been accomplished, after he had been nailed to the cross, after everything had been done to him, after he had been beaten beyond recognition, after a crown of thorns placed on his head, after they had pierced him in the side, after they had nailed him to the tree, nails in his wrists, nails in his feet. He knew that all things were accomplished. He simply said, I thirst. And the Bible said, after he had received the vinegar, he said, it is finished. He ran his race. He finished his course. And he shouted, it is finish. The Bible tells us that he bowed his head and gave up the ghost. He finished his race strong. But the story doesn't end there. 3 days later, we find that he gets up out of the grave. He gets up and makes a statement that helps us finish strong. He says, all power in heaven and earth is in my hand. Oh God, I give you glory. He says he has the keys to death, to the grave. Oh God, I give you praise. Oh death, where is thy sting? Hallelujah. Oh God, I give you glory. God says that we can finish strong. So I'm determined to finish strong. Paul tells us in the word of God, he tells his son Timothy, hallelujah, I've ran my race, I've finished my course, hallelujah. He says, I've kept the faith. Oh God, I give you glory. It does not matter how fast you start. All that matters is how you finish. I came by to tell somebody, by the end of 2022, you can end it strong. You can end it. Oh God, I give you glory. Strong in your faith. Strong in your life. Strong in your commitment to Jesus Christ. How many of us want to finish strong? I know you've been through hell and high water, but you can finish strong. I'm determined to finish this thing that God has given me strong. Hallelujah. Oh God, I give you glory. Determined to finish strong.
Hallelujah. Saints of God, I want you all to hear me today. Hallelujah. I know some of us have been dealing with situations in this life in the past, hallelujah, year. Hallelujah. I thought about, hallelujah, all of the people, just myself, all of the people that I've known in this year that have passed away, hallelujah, and gone on to glory, to be with the Lord, hallelujah. And I thought about how well they lived their life, Hallelujah. Some live them so well. Others, hallelujah, not so well. Oh God, I give you glory. Hallelujah. But it matters how you finish. Hallelujah. Not so much that you got started. We all got started at birth. But it matters how we end in death. Oh God, from the cradle to the grave. Hallelujah. It matters how we finish this race. Hallelujah. Jesus sent me here today to encourage somebody to know, hallelujah, inside themselves. If you want to, that you don't know him as Lord and Savior of your life. Hallelujah. You can finish today strong. You can finish this year strong by giving your life to Christ. You can finish this year strong by turning every situation, every sickness, every disease, everything that you're going through over to him. Hallelujah. Praise the name of our God. Hallelujah. I'm here today to tell you, hallelujah, if you want to finish strong, give it to Jesus. That's what Paul says. He says, I, hallelujah, press toward the mark. He says, not that only did I forget what is behind me, hallelujah, that doesn't mean that you get amnesia. That doesn't mean, hallelujah, that you stick your head in the sand, hallelujah, and you don't remember what you've been through, hallelujah, because the enemy will come and bring you every single day something you have done in your past, hallelujah, but on it. Praise the name of our God. Yes, I did what I said, what you said I did. Hallelujah. But I serve a risen Savior that saved me. And I'm going to finish this race strong. Hallelujah. Praise the name of our God. I want somebody to hear me today. Hallelujah. No matter what you're going through, no matter what you're facing. Hallelujah. Don't give up on Jesus. Don't give up on God. You can finish. You can still finish strong. Oh, God, I give you praise. Paul says it here. He says, not only did I forget what are behind, my past behind me, he says, hallelujah, I reach toward the mark. I reach forward for those things that are before me. In other words, like the example I gave you, he's like a kid with outstretched arms toward Jesus. Jesus is standing at the finish line. Hallelujah. And as you run your race, reach for Jesus. Oh, God, I give you glory. I guarantee you, if you do it, by the time you hit the finish line, Jesus will be there to lift you up. Oh, God, I give you glory to tell you, hallelujah, hallelujah, well done, my good and faithful servant. Oh, God, enter into the rest of your Lord. God bless each and every one of you. May heaven smile upon you. Father, in the name of your son, Jesus, oh, God, we thank you for being, oh God, everything that we need. Thank you, oh God, even in times, hallelujah, that we don't think we can make it, God. You've been faithful to us, oh God, and you've given us your word, hallelujah, to help us in our hours of distress. Father, we thank you for healing virtue that flow, oh God, as only you can. Father, we thank you, oh God, even now, oh God, for bereaved families, oh God, for you being there with them, oh God, and you comforting their hearts and touching them right now, being, oh God, the comfort that they need in this very hour. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus Christ for those under the sound of my voice, oh God, dealing with any issues, hallelujah, in life, oh God, no matter what it is, if it's sickness, if it's lack, oh God, if it's provision, God, anything that they need right now, God, we pray by your power that you would help them to finish this race strong, oh God, that you would provide for them, that you would comfort them, that you would heal them, that you would make a way for them as only you can, God, so that we, hallelujah, might, hallelujah, finish this race strong. Father, we thank you, we praise you, and we glorify you. Father, I pray right now over each and every person under the sound of my voice that you would protect them, protect their homes, their children. Hallelujah. Everything that you have placed in their hands, oh God. Hallelujah. As we complete this year of 2022, take us into 2023, oh God. Hallelujah. In your name, Jesus, we pray. Let us finish this year strong and in your will. And we give you glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. Thank God and amen. Well, God bless each and every one of you.
Saints of God, God bless you and keep you. Heaven smile upon you. I thank you. This has been Pastor Gerald Adams with the Restoration Church Ministries. I give God all the glory and praise and honor for your being here with us. We don't take your time lightly, but we thank God for you, you and you. Thank God and bless the Lord for you. You can stay connected with the Restoration Church Ministries all the time. You can, if you want to join us for Sunday school, you can join us at 10 a.m. on Sunday mornings. Praise the name of our God. The information is on Facebook. We meet on Google's Meet so that we can meet face to face and that we can have a great time in the Lord. We've been having some phenomenal Sunday school lessons. So feel free to join us anytime there. We have morning worship at 11 a.m. on Sunday mornings. We have prayer. And if you have a prayer request, please, you can place it in the chat. If it's of a private nature, you can send it our inbox, Gerald Adams, or The Restoration Church Ministries here on Facebook, and I will get those prayer requests and I will pray over them. Or if you're on Instagram, you can message Pastor GAA. If you're on Instagram, Pastor GAA, you can place it in the chat or you can send a direct message. Hallelujah. Or you can send it through the church's email address, which is restored@trcministries.org. Restored@trcministries.org. And our prayer is on Tuesday and Thursday at 7:30 p.m. And we take those prayer requests before the Lord in prayer. You are always welcome to join us. On Wednesday, we have Bible studies at 7:30 p.m. You are also welcome to join us at that time. I want to personally thank each and every one of you that seeds and sow into this ministry, that give of your hard-earned monies to tithe and offering to the ministry. We thank God for you because you help us do what God has called us to do, to be a blessing even in our community. We thank God for you. And if you want to be a blessing, you can send a gift to The Restoration Church Ministries, P.O. Box 152 in Indian Trail, North Carolina, zip code 28079. That's P.O. Box 152 in Indian Trail, North Carolina. Zip code is 28079. Or you can give electronically if you desire. You can do it if you have Givelify, that app. You can go to Givelify, search The Restoration Church Ministries. You will see a picture of the logo, which is behind me, and a picture of Lady Adams and myself, and know that you're giving in the right place. Or you can give through the church's Cash App, which is $, praise the name of our God, TRC Ministries. That's $, TRC Ministries. And we thank you for your giving. We thank you for your being here. We thank you for all that you do to make the ministry possible. But we thank God most of all for your being here and just being a part of this ministry. God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. May God keep you. Hallelujah. Through the rest of this year, may God just watch over you and your families. Hallelujah. And make a way for you that you finish, hallelujah, strong. Praise the name of our God. Not just only 2022, but you finish life strong. Yes. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Well, God bless you. This has been Pastor Gerald Adams with The Restoration Church Ministries. I love you with the love of the Lord. You're always welcome here where the blood of Jesus covers every gray area of life. Heaven smile upon you and keep you in Jesus' name. God bless you.